Good morning, students. As you are having the signal sense system external exam is on 16 December. I am making some videos which will be very very useful for the preparation of examination. I am going to share some videos which covers the overview of all the signal sense system syllabus. In this particular video, I am going to give the overview of the first unit, that is introduction to signals and system. From the first unit, that is introduction to signals and system, we can expect the minimum of 15 marks. We can expect the minimum of 15 marks from the first unit. So now I am going to give the overview of the first unit, that is introduction to signals and system. Signal is nothing but anything which carries some information is called a signal. We know that anything which carries some information is nothing but signal. A physical quantity which conveys some information is called a signal. But as a professional, we must define the signal sense system. Signal, that is nothing but signal is a single valued function. It is a single valued function, can be dependent on one or more independent variable. If you take any signal in the world, that is a single valued function at any instant of time, any particular point of time, it is a single valued function and it can be dependent on one or more independent variable. That independent variable may be temperature, time, space, position, pressure, distance. All these are nothing but independent variable. If a signal is dependent on only one independent variable, it is called, it is one dimensional signal. If a signal is dependent on more than one independent variable, that is called multi-dimensional signal. So two signals I am defining. Signal is nothing but it is a single function, it is a single value function which can be dependent of one or more independent variable. If the signal is dependent on one independent variable, that is called a one dimensional signal. If the signal is dependent on more than one independent variable, that is named as it is a multi-dimensional signal. Anyway, our signals and system completely deals with a single dimensional signal, so that we are not going to concentrate on the multi-dimensional signal. So that in this complete signals and system, we discuss the complete subject is with the one particular type of signals, that is called one dimensional signals only. So I am defining, once again I am defining the signal. In the examination, sometimes signal will be asked for, definition of the signal will be asked for 2 or 3 marks. Define a signal. Signal is nothing but it is a single value function which can be dependent on one or more independent variable. You can take the very various examples for the signals, that is AC signal, alternating current signal, that may be voltage or current. And ECG is, it is nothing but electrocardiogram. EEG is nothing but electroencephalogram. And the speech signal, and all these are the best example for the signals. So in the signals and system, we are going to study the very basic two types of signals. One is nothing but it is a continuous time signal. Another one is a discrete time signal. Continuous time signal is represented with the x of t, whereas discrete time signal is represented with x of n. Continuous time signal, I can define the continuous time signal is nothing but a signal of continuous amplitude and time. A signal of a continuous amplitude and time is known as continuous time signal or analog signal. This signal will have some value at every instant of time. That means what? The amplitude is continuous and the independent variable, that may be time, is also continuous. That means what? At every instant of time, we can have the signal. These types of signals are named as continuous time signals, and these continuous time signals can be represented with x of t. The best examples for the continuous time signals are sine wave, cosine wave, triangular wave. Then continuous time signal will be represented with the x of t. X of t is nothing but x of t represents a value where t is nothing but it is an independent variable. The best examples for the continuous time is nothing but a sine wave, and it is cosine wave, triangular wave, and all these are the best examples for the continuous time signal. You should remember the continuous time signal definition. That means what? The signal can have at every instant of time, so that is nothing but it is continuous time signal. That amplitude and the time both are in continuous in nature, so that signals are named as continuous time signals. And the next one is about discrete time signals. Discrete time signals nothing but a signal is represented only at a discrete instant of time is named as discrete time. That means what? At some desired instant of times only we can have the signal, and so that amplitude is not continuous in nature and the time is also not continuous in nature, then that type of signal is named as a discrete time signal. And the discrete time signal is represented with the x of n. N is nothing but independent variable, and x of n in total we can call it is a discrete time signal. And the best examples for the discrete time signal, if we take the blood pressure readings of a patient after every 1 hour and plot the graph, then the resultant signal will be a discrete time signal only. That means what? If you have the patient, if you wanted to note the blood pressure of that patient for every 1 hour, if you put the same readings onto a graph, and that will be the discrete time signal. So that discrete time signal is a one. We can have the signal at a discrete instant of time only, and these two signals sometimes can be asked for the short answer questions. So define continuous time signal with example, and define discrete time signal with the example. And you have to define the continuous time signal, and it can be represented with the x of t, and you should give the example. And here you have to define the discrete time signal, and it can be represented with the x of n, and it can be you can give the any example for the discrete time. So that there are these two signals. Based on these two signals only we are going to study the entire signals and system. Then next one, there are four basic types of signals. In the first unit we have to cover, first one is called unit step signal. Unit step signal is denoted with u of n if it is continuous time signal, and if it is discrete time signal that can be represented of u of n. And the next signal we can call it is a ramp signal. Ramp signal is denoted as r of t. It is a continuous time signal, and if it is a discrete time signal that is r of n. This is a unit step signal and it is a ramp signal. And next one is a impulse signal. Impulse signal, if it is a continuous time, that is del of t, and if it is discrete time we can call it is del of n. And the next one is a exponential function. Exponential function is simply represented with the x of t or x of n only, and that x of t is represented as exponential function in continuous time, and x of n is represented, that is same exponential function, in the discrete time. And we are going to discuss these and with respect to the mathematical expressions, and any of these four will be asked for the 2 or 3 marks for the short answer question. Define unit step signal. Define continuous time unit step signal. Define continuous time ramp signal. Defines unit impulse signal or delta function. Define exponential function. Like that you can be asked for 2 or 3 marks from the basic signals. And the next one is about system. System is nothing but a system. We can give the system definition. A system is a physical device. A system is a physical device that generates a response or output signal for a given input signal. That means what? System is nothing but it is a meaningful interconnection of various components, and to that device we will be giving the input signal, and the input signal goes into that particular device and it takes some manipulations and it delivers the output, so that that system is nothing but it is a physical device that generates the output for a given input signal. And this concept of system can be applicable for the various fields of electronics, electrical, communications, chemical and mechanical engineering. Like that, anywhere the system concept has been implementing, so that generally system representation will be like this. This is a system. System is nothing but it is a meaningful interconnection of various component, and to which we are giving the input signal, that is x of t you can call, and for giving the input signal it can generate the response, and response is nothing but it is the output. Generally output is nothing but you can represent output with the y of t, so that y of t I can write y of t is a output, and we have been getting this y of t as a output by going through the some various manipulations on the input signal, so that that manipulations will be provided by the function that is called transfer function, that is t, and the y of t is nothing but the transfer function applied on x of t. This is the system description mathematical equation. Y of t is the output and x of t is the input, and the input signal we have been operating the system. That means what the system in the input signal is getting into the system, so that it has been taking some manipulations and finally it is generating the response, that is nothing but output. So that y of t is nothing but transfer function applied on x of t, and that is nothing but it is a system definition. And you can take the example for the any system. Definition of the system is very simple. It is a meaningful interconnection of various devices, various components, and it is a physical device which generates the response or output, which generates the response or output for the given input signal. And mathematically it can be represented as y of t is equals to transfer function applied on x of t. Like that, you can go with the definition and the examples. And example, best example for the system is you can take the rectifier. Rectifier is a system which converts alternating current to direct current, that is AC to DC. It converts AC to DC, so that input is AC signal, output we have been getting the DC signal, and the system is composed with the various components like diodes, transistors and the capacitors, inductors, and all these are composed in a meaningful way such that it converts AC to DC. That system name we can call it is a rectifier. So in the system we are having the various types of systems we are going to study, and sometimes, and this will be asked for the 2 or 3 marks. That means what? Classification of, give the all the classifications of signal, in which the first classification of signal, that is nothing but it is a static or dynamic signal. First I am going with the signal name, that is static or a dynamic signal. First signal name, system name is, it is a static signal, static or dynamic. Definition, I will give you the definition, and from this all these seven types of signals we can expect the one Lang answer question also, that is for 10 marks, so that it is very very important. And here also the basic signals also very very important, and from this we can expect one short answer questions. And operations on the signals, we will expect the one more Lang answer question. First one is a static or dynamic system. Second one is about causal and a non-causal system. Causal or non-causal system. Next one is about linear and non-linear system. Linear and non-linear or non-linear system. Next one is about, we can go with the next one is time invariant and time variant system. Time invariant and the time variant system. Next one is a analog system and the digital system. Analog or a digital system. And we know that continuous time system and discrete time system. Likewise, lumped parameter system and the distributed parameter. Lumped parameters and the distributed parameter. Lumped and the distributed parameter. That means what? The classification of systems will be asked for 2 or 3 marks. Explain or list the classification of filter will be list the classifications of system will be asked for 2 or 3 marks. First classification is static or dynamic system. Next one is a causal or non-causal system. Next one is linear or non-linear system. Next one is a time invariant and the time variant system. Next one, analog or digital system, continuous time and the discrete time system, lumped parameter and the distributed parameter system. This will be asked for 2 or 3 marks. Then I am going to explain the one of the important question, important topic. From this we can expect the one long answer question, that is nothing but operations on signals. Operations on signals. From this we can expect the 110 marks question. From this we can expect the 110 marks question we can expect, that is operations and signal. So that it is very very important in the examination point of view. From the unit 1 there are only 2 types of long answer questions are possible. One is about the signals, another one is about the system. In this signals we can have the long answer question is that the plot the given signal, plot the given signal by mentioning that heading, and you can be asked to plotting of the 2 signals A and B, and that will be for 10 marks. And second question, second possible question from the first unit, that is nothing but it is the check the whether following systems are static or dynamic, check the following systems are linear or non-linear, like that you can be asked to solve some problems. So 2 questions only possible to ask in the for the long answer question. One is signals and another one is system. Then I am going with the one important question, that is operations on signal. First one, operations on signal. There are 3 operations on signals. First one is about time shifting operation. Time shifting operation. Time scaling operation. Time reversal operation. Then first one I am going with the time shifting operation. I am having XFT. XFT is what? Which type of signal? It is a continuous time signal on which I am applying the time shifting operation. So that resultant signal will be X of T plus or minus capital T. So from this you can write the 2 equations. One is X of T plus capital T. Next one is X of T minus capital T. If it is X of T plus capital T, then the new signal compared to the X of T, that is about the advanced signal. This is a original signal. X of T is a original signal. And X of T plus T is the new signal. And so that the new signal will be the advanced signal. This is advanced signal compared to the original signal. Then X of T minus T, this is nothing but X of T is a original signal and the new signal will be X of T minus T, that is called it is a delayed signal. It is a delayed signal. So that in a practical we cannot find the advanced and the delayed signal, and we are going with the one of the problem based on the time shifting operation. Let X of T is given like this. X of T is, this is X of T, and it is having the signal is like this. This is T and this is X of T, and the signal is there from minus 2 to plus 2. then plot, you can be asked to plot the signal, then plot, then plot x of t minus 2 and t x of t plus 2, two signals. So that means what? If you combinedly write these two, that is x of t plus r minus 2 only. If you combinedly write these two as x of t plus r minus 2, from that you can have the one signal is x of t plus 2, another signal is x of t minus 2. From the given statement, if it is x of t plus 2, that is an advanced signal, that means this is advanced one. And if it is x of t minus 2, that will be the delayed one. So that how it will be, I'll explain now. So that first signal is what? Original signal is x of t only. Original signal is x of t. This is x of t and it is t. And the signal is there from minus 2 to plus 2. Minus 2 and plus 2. Then we have to go with the x of t plus 2. First one, I am going with x of t plus 2. Simple. You should take the independent variable. T plus 2 is equals to 0. Then t is equals to what? T is equals to minus 2. Minus indicates it is the left side. And 2 indicates it is by 2 units. Left to side. It has to shift the left side by 2 units. So that it shift left side by 2 units means this complete signal will shift left side by the 2 units. This is 2 and this is 1 and it is minus 1 and it is 2. That means shift to 2 units means if it shift by 1 unit means this signal comes here and this signal comes here, this signal comes here, this signal comes here. But it has to shift to 2 times so that 2 times means this is 1 unit and this is 2 unit. The total signal will start from here. The total duration is minus 2 to 2 means it is 4 seconds. So that it will be start from the minus 4 to 0. So that new signal I am drawing it is x of t plus 2 is nothing but it is t. And it shift the right side by the 2 units so that it shift the left side by the 2 units, sorry, and it is minus 4 and it is a 0. The total signal duration is about 4 only and here also 4 only. We are not changing the signal characteristics. We are shifting the signal from our original position to left side. Now compared to the original signal, this signal is advanced signal only. Earlier the signal is there at minus 2 onwards. But then now the signal is there from the minus 4 onwards. And this signal is advanced signal to the original signal. It is advanced signal to the original signal. And coming to the next plot, what we have to do? Next plot is nothing but it is x of t minus 2. Next we have to go with the next signal, that is x of t minus 2. Where t minus 2 is equals to 0, t minus 2 is equals to 0 means t is equals to 2, 2 means it is positive, positive means it shift right side by how many units? By the 2 units, so that the total signal will shift right side, the total signal will shift right side by the 2 units. Now the signal will be like this, this is a 0 and it is 4, so that now this, if you compare this signal to the original signal and the signal is there at 2 only, from minus 2 to plus 2 only, then now the signal is there for 0 to 4 compared to this 2, compared to original signal, the new signal will be the delayed signal. This signal is nothing but delayed signal. So that what is the conclusion we can do? By using the time shifting operation, we can get either the advanced signal or delayed signals. Conclusion is that x of t is a continuous time signal on which we have been performing the time shifting operation. So that there will be the two cases, x of t plus t. If capital T is positive, the capital T is positive, that will be the advanced signal. If the capital T is negative, that will be the delayed signal. Likewise, you can go with the operations of signal first operation, that is nothing but it is the time shifting operation. Next one, I am going with the time reversal operation, and by using this one you can go with the discrete time also. Discrete time signal means what? We are having the x of n is a original signal. If you go with the time shifting operation, that will be x of n plus or minus capital N, such that we can get the two signal, that is x of n minus n and x of n plus n, and this will be, it is nothing but it is the, this is a delayed signal and this is a advanced signal. Likewise, you can go with the discrete time also. Then I am going with the next operation on signal, that is a time reversal operation. I am going with the time reversal operation of the signal. Second operation is time reverse. Time reversal operation. Time reversal operation on signal. Let x of t is a signal, that is a continuous time signal, on which we are performing the reversal, time reversal operation, so that the resultant new signal will be x of minus t. That means what? X of t is original signal, then we are going with the new signal, that is new signal is nothing but it is the time reversal of the original signal. This is the condition. So that in case of time shifting operation, we have the x of t, but by using the time shifting operation, by employing the one independent variable to the time, that we got the y of t. Y of t is equals to x of t plus or minus capital T. This is what it is, time shifting operation. Now this is a time reversal operation. This is the condition, or this is the mathematical expression for the time reversal operation. This is the mathematical expression for the time shifting operation. So that I am going to give the example of the time reversal operation by solving one problem. Then I am going to solve one problem. From that you can easily understand what is the time reversal operation. Now I am going with the time reversal operation here. Let x of t, this is a signal, x of t, I am having the signal. This is 0 and it is 4 seconds and it is t. This is x of t. Then we have to plot the y of t. Y of t is nothing but x of minus t. I should go with the x of minus t. So that what will be the x of minus t? This is t. The signal is there from 0 to 4 where t is positive. But we require to go with t is negative, same values. That means what? Whatever the time instants are there, that will be replaced by the minus value. Minus will comes to the second quadrant, so that I can have the signal is like this. Simply folding that signal, so that we can get that is in the second quadrant, so that it is 0 remains same only, 4 will be the minus 4. We are not changing the amplitude of the signal, so that it remains same only. This particular signal is named, that is it, a time reversal. So that by employing the time reversal signal, we can have the signal in the opposite quadrant. That means what? If you have the signal is first quadrant, you can get the second signal is in second quadrant. If you have the signal is second quadrant, you can fold it to first quadrant. If you have the signal is third quadrant, that will be folded to the fourth quadrant. If you have the signal in fourth quadrant, that will be folded to the third. So this is the condition. So I am going with the little bit complex one in the time reversal operation. Then I am going with the example. This is x of t signal. I am going with the x of t. This is a signal. This is x of t. We have to go with the x of minus. This is x of t. And we have to go with the time reversal operation of this one. X of minus t. Plot the x of minus t. X of minus t will be like this. simply mirror image only. This signal comes here, this signal comes here, because first quadrant will be second quadrant will be first quadrant, third will be fourth, fourth will be third. Same signal you can plot now. So if you fold this one, this signal comes here, so that you can get the signal is here, and you can get the signal is here. If you fold this one, and you can get the signal is here, and the signal will be like this. So this is nothing but it is the time reversal operation of one particular signal. This is the original signal, this is original signal, and this will be the folded signal, that is nothing but reversal signal or the inversion signal, that is a mirror image signal. So we can call it is mirror image signal. We can call the next one is this is a mirror image signal. In a general application, reverse signal is nothing but if you are having the voice or the video signal, if that is played in the reverse manner, that is nothing but the reversal operation applied on the original signal only. This is a time reversal operation. Next one, I'm going to cover the next important thing, then it is very very important, and plot the given signal. I'm going with the one of the important question, most of you having the doubts in this one. Plot xf minus 2 plus 2 of the given signal, where xf of the given signal is like this. Xf t, this is t, then I can go with the signal is like this. This is a signal. This is the signal x of t. It is x of t. Now what we have to plot? We have to plot x of minus t plus 2. That means what? From this we can do the two things. One, we have to do the time shifting operation. Another one, we have to do the time reversal operation. Time reversal operation also we must perform. Time reversal operation and the time shift. First you have to go with the time shifting operation, or first you have to go with the time reversal operation. Then I am going with the reversal operation. Then what I'll get? Time reversal operation is nothing but x of minus t. X of minus t will be, signal will be like this. This is the time reversal operation. This is 0 and it is minus 4. Then x of minus t is completed. Then we have to go with the x of minus t plus 2. X of minus t plus 2. That means what? Signal will be x of minus t plus 2. So that take this complete. Minus t plus 2 is equals to 0. Then minus t is equals to minus 2. Minus 2, so that minus minus cancel. It is nothing but t is equals to plus 2 only. That means what? It is plus is nothing but right side by how many units? By the 2 units. So that on which we are doing, so that we are going to do this one, it is a resultant signal will be x of minus t plus 2. X of minus t plus 2. That means what? This will be shifted 2 units by the right side, so that earlier signal is there at minus 4, now the signal will be there at minus 2 only, so that signal will be like this and like this. This is nothing but it is a x of minus t plus 2. So whenever the signal is there in the form of x of minus t plus 2, x of minus t plus 2, that is nothing but it is involved the reversal operation followed by the shifting operation. First you have to do the reversal operation, After that, whatever the independent term is there, you have to equate to zero, so that from that you have to do the shifting operation on the reversal signal, and that will be the your signal. Then next one is about the next part is nothing but it is a time scaling. Next operation is nothing but time scaling operation. I'm going to do it one time scaling operation. Time scaling operation. I'm having x of t and time scaling. Due to the time scaling operation, the signal has manipulated, that is x of a t. If a is greater than 1, if a is greater than 1, x of a t will be, it is a compressed signal. It is compressed signal. If a is less than 1, x of a t will be, it is expanded signal. So conclusion is nothing but there are three operations we can perform on the signal. First is time shifting operation. By making use of time shifting operation, either we can get the advanced signal or delayed signal. Second one is about time reversal operation. By making use of the time reversal operation, we can flip the signal from first quadrant to second quadrant, second to first quadrant, and coming to the third to fourth and fourth to third. We will be getting the signal in the reverse manner. And the last operation is nothing but time scaling. Time scaling is nothing but we are multiplying the independent variable with a constant, that is a. If a is greater than 1, the new signal, that is x of a t, that will be a compressed signal. If a is less than 1, that signal will be expanded signal. I'll explain that one. What is compressed signal and what is expanded signal? Then I'm going with the x of t. I'm having x of t. It is a continuous time signal, and the signal is mentioned like this. The signal is there for minus a to plus a. Whose amplitude is, assume that it is x. Then I am going with the new signal. From this I am going with the new signal by making use of the time shifting, time scaling operation, x of a t, and in which I am going with the x of 2t. First time I am going with x of 2t. That means what? Here in place of a is equals to, we kept that is a is equals to 2, that is nothing but it is greater than 1. If a is greater than 1, if a is greater than 1, x of a t will be, x of a t will be compressed signal. Compressed signal. That means what? X of a t will be, it is x of 2t and it is t. A is equals to what? We have 2. So that each instant of time will be, each time interval will be divided by that 2. So that minus a, this is plus a. That means what? I can have it is minus a by 2 and it is plus a by 2. The signal remains same, only amplitude we are not changing. That is, it is x. That means what? Signal is compressed. Signal is compressed. Earlier we have the signal minus 4, minus a to plus a, but now the signal is there at from minus a by 2 to plus a by 2. And if you take any numerical for the a also, I can go with the one more example, that is x of t is given like this. X of t, this is x of t, this is 0 and it is 4 seconds and it is x of t. This is a given signal. Then the question will be, plot x of 2t and x of 1 by 2t. This is the signal. So that means what? We are having the one particular signal, that is x of t. From that we have to plot the two more new signals. So that here x of a t is equal, first one I am taking x of a t is equals to what we have, x of 2t. A is equals to what we have, 2 is greater than 1. So if it is greater than 1, each time interval has to be divided by that a, so that resultant signal will be like this. This is x of 2t resultant signal, and it is t 0. This is go with this is sorry this is assume that it is 1. It is 1. For our convenience, make it as 2. So that means what? Each time interval has to be divided by 2. That means what? It is 2 by 2. Already a is 2, right? 2 by 2 is what? 1. So that instead of starting at 2, it started at 1 only. Then 4. 4 by 2, it is 2 only. The signal remains same. Now it is a compressed signal. If a is greater than 1, if a is greater than 1, 2 is nothing but it is greater than 1 only. Compared to this signal, this is, it is compressed signal. It is compressed signal. That means what? If we play an audio signal in a fast forward mode, and we can call that is a compressed signal. If you play audio or video signal in a fast forward mode, and we can complete that video with the small duration only, complete compared to the original duration, we can complete it is very fast. So that it is a compressed signal. Then I can go with the next signal, that is nothing but x of 1 by 2 t. That means what you have to go with, it is x of a t is equals to, x of a t is equals to what we can call x of 1 by 2 t. 1 by 2 t, that means what? Here we are going with a is equals to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is less than 1, and so that the resultant signal will be expanded. Expanded by what? Expanded by 2. Earlier we have divided each time interval by 2. Now you have to multiply each time interval by 2, so that 2 into 2, it is minus 2 into 2, it is minus 4, and plus 4 into 2, that will be 8. So that I can have the signal is like this. This is minus 2 into 2, it is minus 4. 4 into 2, it is 8. Signal will be like this. This is nothing but it is a expanded signal or expansion signal compared to this is a original signal and this is a new signal. It is nothing but it is an expansion signal, so that you have to go with the signal. Then I am going to solve the one particular problem based on that one. The total three operations will be completed. Plot, question is nothing but plot x of minus 3 by 2 t plus 2 of a given signal. Then I am going with the signal now. Signal is there like this. This is x of t. And then signal, what we can take? The signal is this is 0 and 4. Clear? Then otherwise you can go with it is 6. Then whenever you find this type of thing, first you have to go with the reversal operator. First reversal operation, on the reversal operation you have to perform, on the reversal operations you have to perform the shifting, second one. Shifting and the third one after shifting operation you should go with the scaling. Three things. First one is what? Reversal, because minus is there, so that I am going with the x of minus t. I will be plotting now. X of minus t. X of minus t I am plotting. So this is x of t. X of minus t will be like this. Here this is 6 is there. 0 is there. 0 remains same only. 6 will be replaced by minus 6 because t is replaced by minus t. T is replaced by minus 3. First one is completed. Reversal operation is completed. Next one is what? It is a shifting operation. Next one is a shifting operation. That means what? Minus t plus 2 it is. Minus t plus t. This is a scaling only. 3 by 2 is nothing but scaling only. That is don't consider now. So that 3 by 2 is not there. So that minus t plus 2 is equals to 0. T is equals to minus t is equals to minus 2. Minus minus cancel and it is positive. Then t is positive. It shift right side by how many units? 2 units. Then I am going with the shifting operation now. By it shift by the 2 unit. That is x of minus t plus 2. It shift 2 units by the right side. Right side means this. Earlier signal is there at minus 6. So that we can have the signal from minus 2 onwards only. Minus 2 to now it is 2. It is minus 4 and it is plus 2. Now this is what it is? Signal. Then we have to apply the scaling operation. Scaling operation, what we have? X of AT is equals to what we have? X of 3 by 2 T. 3 by 2, that means what? A is equals to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is nothing but it is 1.5. 1.5 is nothing but what it is? 1.5 is greater than 1. Greater than 1 means signal will be compressed. Signal will be compressed. That means what? Each instant of time is divided by 1.5. That means what? The signal is there. It is x of minus 3 by 2 t plus 2. Minus 4 is divided by 0.5. Minus 4 is divided by 0.5. You can get that is here. That is 1 or 2 point something. So that it is minus 2 point something. And it is 2 by what it is? 1.5. 2 by 1.5 is nothing but it is more than 0 to 1. So that signal will be like this. It is a compressed signal. If A is greater than 1, it is compressed signal. Just now we discussed. And if you have any doubt, and you can go with like this also. Here, 3 by 2 is there. It is greater than 1 only. So that you simply go with minus 4 by 3 by 2. That means what? Minus 4 by 1 into, that is what? Minus 4 by 1 into this will be 2 by 3. That is what? 8 by 3. 8 by 3 means it is near to 3 only. It is 2 point something. And coming to here, it is 2 by 3 by 2. 2 by 3 by 2 is what? 2 by 1 into 2 by 3. It is 4 by 3. 4 by 3 means almost 1 after. 1.13. Like that you can calculate the thing, so that this is about complete signals and on the signals and their operation. The next video I'll cover the basic signals, that is the 4 basic signals are there, and with this the half part of the first unit will be closed.